हेलो फ्रेंड, दिस इज संजय कुमार, क्रिएटर ऑफ सेलेक्टर्स हब। रिक्वेस्ट यू, इफ यू आर न्यू हियर, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल सो यू डोंट मिस एनी अपकमिंग इनोवेशन एंड अपडेट्स ऑन सेलेक्टर्स हब और टेस्टकेस स्टूडियो। थैंक यू। नाउ सेलेक्टर्स हब इज गोइंग टू हेल्प यू एंड टेल यू अप फ्रेंड दैट इफ यू विल यूज XPath और इफ यू विल ट्राई टू ऑटोमेट दिस वेब एलिमेंट, देन वॉट एरर यू विल गेट इन ऑटोमेशन। So that like you will not be wasting any more time like trying to automate that particular element or looking out why that error you are getting. So now you will be getting that this information upfront. Let's see what is all about. And before that, let's see what is the problem statement selector sub is going to solve you and where you are wasting time today without this innovation. So let's say on this page library, suppose we have to click on this button here. Okay, so what generally we do, like we right click, inspect the element, and here in the DOM you see that there are a couple of elements. So suppose you might have clicked on this button here while inspecting, so you see that this is a tag, image tag, and then this is button. Okay, and you open selectors hub here. So you will see that here it is generating relative XPath, everything is there for this particular element. Okay, now if you copy this XPath and try pasting here and verify this XPath, it is showing one element matching. So this is perfect that yes, we can use this XPath in our automation script, and let's use this XPath in our automation script. Okay, so this is, I have already written here. So this is the similar XPath which we have written, and now we will run this script, execute this script. So you see that the element is there in the UI, the XPath is matching, it is showing one matching node, and everything is fine. But still we will see that our script will fail while executing. It will say that element is non-interactable. Let's see what happens. Here our script execution failed because of this exception, element not interactable exception, element not interactable. But you see that this element is there, right? Like if we see here in the browser, you see that this element is there in the DOM, this XPath is matching here. Even if, like, you might think that if we will refresh the page, or if we will let's say if we open through automation window, this XPath will be there or not. Yes, it is there and it's still matching one element. But why our script is failing? Because this element, this kind of element, doesn't have any area, any visible area in the UI, in the web page. So you see, when you hover on this element, there is nothing which is highlighting here, you see. But when you hover on this A, it is highlighting, yes, this is a viewable area there. There's an interactable area. So if any element will not have any interactable area, then on those kind of elements, Selenium or any automation framework will not be able to perform the action, and they will throw the error, that non-interactable element. And how you can understand about this, you can check for this element in the console here. Let me show you. $0 dot offset height or width, you see that it is showing zero. And some kind of element like which has the display none, visibility hidden, so all those things will be taken care by now selectors hub. One more example, let me show you here on selectors hub website. For this kind of element, let's say Twitter, these logos are there. If you right click on inspect, and you will see that here this eye icon, this span is there. So this span, we will feel like we will try to write XPath which are for those element which looks, it's stable, some text is there, some stable text is there. So for here Twitter is there and span, so this looks very much stable. So we feel that we can write the XPath for this element, and this is under this A, which is the anchor tag, like which is Twitter, for Twitter this one. So we feel that we can write the XPath for this element. But if you see that the XPath which is stable, yes, and if you verify, yes, it is showing here one element matching. But we cannot use this XPath region because this doesn't have any viewable area here, You see that when you hover on this element, nothing is highlighting in the UI. When you hover on this, then it is highlighting. So for this, there is a viewable area, but for this element, there is no viewable area. So for that purpose, like it will fail. Exception, Selenium automation will give you the exception. So how Selector Sub is going to help you? And how Selector Sub is going to, so as soon as you inspect this element, you might have already noticed this, it is showing this alert message here that this element is not interactable through Selenium automation as it is not visible in UI. Try any nearby element. So you can try any nearby element and then you can perform the action. Similarly, like here in Debris, this for this element it was failing, right? So this is, you see that before you getting error in your automation, you are using that element, you are using that locator in your automation, Selector Sub will tell you upfront that there is an error, that you will get this error. This element is not interactable through Selenium automation as it is not visible in UI. So try any nearby elements. Selector Sub is going to tell you upfront. You will not have to waste any more time. Today, you won't believe, like many people are struggling with this kind of problem and they waste a huge, huge amount of time. Reason? Because you will feel like the element is there, XPath is correct, but still it is not performing the action. What could be the issue? And this just like make people very much upset that they feel like everything is there, but still my script is failing and nowhere you get the answer. Also, in many interviews also, interviewer will ask you that, see, look, this element is there. It is in the DOM. XPath is matching. XPath is not changing. XPath is also stable. But why script is failing? Such scenarios you will find in most of the interviews everywhere. So to learn about these concepts, now Selector Sub will help you upfront. Also, like if you start inspecting element here, Selector Sub will tell you that whether this element is interactable or not. So if element will be interactable, then that message will not show here. But if you inspect any element for which you can't perform action through automation, that it will show you like this. So you can keep inspecting element here and you will get the information from Selector Sub. So this will really help you guys a lot to learn a lot of good concepts as well as save a huge amount of time. And you, if you want to learn more about such concepts like why these things are coming, for which kind of elements it will be coming, and a lot more like what kind of elements are those. So all those information, if you want to learn in more deep, you can join this training here. I have already started a training on XPath, Web Elements, and DOM knowledge. So this training will really help you guys a lot. So you can join the training here. Just click on this link here and it will take you to, on Selector Sub website as well. You will find the training tab. Here you can register for whichever, like multiple batches I have created. One batch is already running. So you can join any of the batch according to your time zone and availability. Register here and learn all these concepts related to selectors, XPath, Web Element, and DOM. Okay, so this you will get upfront, which is going to save a lot of effort and time for you, as well as you will learn things that, okay, for this element, automation is not possible, for which kind of element automation will be possible. So all those things you will get the information right there upfront from the Selector Sub itself. Like for this element, this is a comment, so Selector Sub will tell you that this is comment. It was, this feature is already there, was already there. Okay, and few more things has, good things has been added now. Earlier, like when you're inspecting the Shadow DOM element, when you're inspecting the SVG element, so Selector Sub used to give you the information that this is inside iframe, it is SVG element. But earlier it was just giving you the information that through here, like it used to change the color of this element and it used to tell you that this is SVG from here. But now you will have a better message so that like nobody will skip these things and they everyone would be able to learn that this is SVG element and it doesn't support standard XPath format. So now you will be concerned, like you will be putting more extra effort here and looking carefully that, oh, there's some, this is something special. So you will look at this XPath. You, when you will write XPath for this one, you will see that there is a different format of writing XPath for SVG, SVG child element. Because if you write double forward slash svg, it will tell you that this is invalid XPath format. So this way you will get to know that what is right format, wrong format from here. Similarly, like for shadow DOM elements, now if you will inspect any element which is inside shadow DOM, outside shadow DOM, it will give you the information. So earlier also it was giving you like in shadow DOM here, but that was not enough. Many people had ignored that or might not have noticed. So now selector sub will give you an alert message here in big and bold color, so that like you will have at least a look once on that and you will learn this. Because still, like I had few days back, I did a poll on LinkedIn and almost 80% people said that yes, we can access shadow DOM elements through XPath, which is not correct, guys. So I felt like very much disappointed that still people are not aware about this concept, though it's been almost more than 1 year I have been trying to teach you all, and through selector sub is also trying to teach you all, but still people are missing these kind of basic concepts related to selectors, XPath, web elements. So this is where these things has been added now, and I'm sure it will help you that to learn this concept, that element which are inside shadow DOM will not support XPath, doesn't support XPath, and you will have to use the CSS selector, and a lot more information is there here. So hope this will help you guys. Similarly, for iframe, like earlier it used to show that this is in frame, in iframe, but the clear message was not there. So many people, those who are beginner or those who haven't explored selector sub much, was not able to understand that much. But now you will have this alert message here that this element is inside iframe. Switch inside iframe to access this element through automation. So you will learn these concepts automatically, and you will be knowing what you are supposed to do for this particular element to perform the automation. So I hope this will help you guys a lot. These features will be available, are available from 4.0.8 onwards. So please update, and I hope you guys will enjoy these features, and this will really, really help you guys a lot. And big thanks to Gaurav Khurana, who suggested this feature, to add this feature in selector sub, so that like people will not face any issue and they will get to know this information, that this kind of elements are non-interactable, like if any element which is not viewable. So he was trying to automate some of the application. He was trying to automate this Twitter and social media links at the selector sub website in the bottom, and then that's where he got to know, like he got this error, and he suggested like, Sanjay, can we add this feature? So this is where we he suggested the idea for this one, and we added this here, and I'm sure this will help you guys a lot. And again, if you want to learn more about such concepts related to XPath, do register for this training. And if you feel that selector sub is helping you guys in your business and helping you in learning and other stuff, please consider a small donation here to grow this selector sub product, Test Cases Studio free community product, and so that we can help you guys, I can help you guys more on this such kind of innovations and help you guys to learn these concepts. With that, thank you so much guys, and if you haven't subscribe to the channel. Please like and share selector sub with everyone, let everyone know about these amazing concepts and this innovative tool, so that they can save their time and they can learn the right concepts. With that, thank you so much guys.